Can you imagine this showing up at somebody's birthday party, ready to perform? Reeking of cheap gin and... I'm gonna go out on a limb here and guess piss and regret. Hey everyone, Mr. David Ray here, and I hope you're ready and down to clown. For today's video, I wanted to do a quick primer for the clown. What's his deal? What's he all about? And how can you hopefully suck just a little bit less at him after watching this video? The main takeaways for clown are this. Throw a bottle, slow the survivor, waddle your thick clown legs and booty to catch up to the survivor, smack him with your knife, rinse, repeat. It's not a super sexy or glamorous life as the clown in Dead by Daylight, but you can be an absolute beast with clown if you can time your bottle throws just right, and you already have some basic knowledge of how survivors tend to loop around structures. Let's go over some basics of the clown's power with some recent gameplay, and then we'll end the video with a quick match to show you the clown in action. One of the big things that new clown players struggle with is where and when to throw bottles to slow survivors with the tonic. I'm going to show a handful of recent throws with the clown, and I'll walk you through each one as they're happening. Then I'll end the video with a full clown match so you can see him in action. Alright, for this, we see there's a generator up ahead. We want to try to throw our bottle to the right of that to hopefully push the survivor to the left here and into our arms. Alright, bottle throw. Ace runs out. Now he does have a pallet around this corner. He uses it, but we break it and get this resource out of the way. This is later on. We've injured him. We're in chase. We want to try to throw a bottle right ahead of him at his feet to hopefully slow him down so we can get our hit. All right, there's the bottle throw. We're just waiting out a dead hard. He's looking behind him a lot. Doesn't have dead hard. Knock him down. All right, same generator a little bit later on in the match. Again, throw the bottle. Push the survivor out into our arms. We get a hit. Now, Yoichi is looking ahead to the left. He's either going to go to the left or to the right and fake us out. We have our bottle primed and ready. Let's wait and see what he does. He goes to the left. We want to throw this bottle, try to get ahead of him and into the building to land in front of him. It does, so we can follow this up. He has a pallet. We get it out of the way. You're going to be getting a lot of pallets out of the way. All right, so for this, we know they're healing under hook. We want to try to interrupt that, so we want to hit Yunjin right on the head. Let's see. Boop. Smack it with a knife. Excellent. Alright, for this, we're approaching Killer Shack. We suspect somebody's inside. We want to try to get this bottle to land in the center of the shack to spread, hopefully hit somebody. It does, but he has a pallet. We're getting it out of the way. You're going to be getting a lot of pallets out of the way of the clown. That's the name of the game. Alright, this, new map, new match. We spot a survivor off in the distance. It's a Fang. We want to try to see what she's going to do. She doesn't run out into this clearing. That's smart. She's hiding behind this box and this pallet. So we're going to throw a bottle behind this rock structure to block that backside off and follow it up and go around to this side. Alright, she is standing there. So what we want to do is throw a bottle to hit that rock. We want to make this as unsafe as possible and hopefully push her out into this clearing. So now we're going to walk around back to this side, see her right there just waiting for us. So she's going to have to walk back through the gas if she wants that pallet. We get the hit. All right, we're going to follow this up. Slow her down again. She has another pallet here. We're just going to try to swing. We're getting pallets out of the way. All right. Slow her down again and just swing through this pallet and knock her down. Alright, so as you can see, what we're trying to do is get rid of as many resources as possible while also getting hits. Survivors love to hide behind pallets if they're facing a clown. It's a pretty safe space for them, but you want to make those pallets as unsafe as possible and get them out of the way survivors can't use them later on in the match. Let's jump into some actual gameplay. This was just a random match that I had a few nights ago. I'll walk you through some of what my thought process is when I'm playing clown, where I'm going, what I'm looking for, and I'll walk you through some of my throws as they're happening. So enjoy. Okay, Temple of Purgation. This is a fine map for clown. I don't find clown to be too map dependent. Alright, so let's figure out where survivors are likely to be. I'm guessing this back corner. We're going to go inside this temple, try to scan these back walls. We hear somebody, drop down, give him a smack. Catch those survivors off guard. Alright, let's try to slow him down. Alright, so he doesn't go out the entrance, the main one. He drops down, we follow this up. We're trying to make him going outside as unappealing as possible through multiple exits. All right, let's get you on a hook. I always like to refill after I down or hook a survivor. So just always get in the habit of refilling, even if you only have used one or two bottles. All right, so just go trick hit this. Don't see a survivor. That's fine, no. All right. Somebody did just go for the unhook. Let's just follow this up. Yeah, we don't want healing underhook. So hit him, farm a save the best for last stack. Throw that bottle through the pallet. Go around the other side, swing. Get that hit. And that toolbox. Love using Franklin's own clown. All right, so she is running upstairs. Now, we don't know if this is just a window upstairs or just a drop down. All right, she doesn't play with our mind game. Okay, there is no window, so we can just sort of run up, follow this. Now she's gonna have to run through that smoke. No! All right, just drop down and hit her. All right, we can take her back to the Scourge Hook. Get more Scourge Hook value. All right, refill. All right, they did jump back on this generator. There is a Kate. Let's take that toolbox. Now she's running in there. Somebody is going to go for the save. I think Leon was just teabagging at the hook. I don't know why he would do that, but let's give him a smack for it. All right, she wants to try to body block and take a hit. So whenever survivor does that, hit him and then follow it up. You wanna body block? We'll gladly chase you again. So back on hook you go, Yunjin. Okay. Somebody is on this. It is a Jonah. Let's knock him down and let Jill take care of the gen for us. Now he's got boil over. And I don't see a good hook nearby, so we're just going to drop him on the ground. She wants to body block again. I don't know why you're trying to do this. Maybe we can, I don't think we can make it to this hook because we're on the wrong side. So we're going to drop her. All right, now let's get him on a hook. Nice little tea bags there from Leon. All right, let's throw you up on the hill. All right, they're not healing under hook. Smart. Let's refill. They're just jumping on this gen injured. Alright, now we saw Kate run over here. I guess she's just waiting around for us. I don't know. Alright, Jonah's still down on the ground. Let's throw him over on this hook. And Yunjin and Leon are both injured, so we're in a pretty good spot right now. Alright, somebody went for the save. I'm assuming that Yunjin, because we heard her crying earlier. Yep. Alright, so throw gas at the entrance and exit points when you're going into a shack for an unhook. Try to slow them down as they're running away. Alright, that is Yunjin out of the match. Kate is waiting for us right here. Alright, let's get you on a hook. Alright, that was pretty quick. Let's go find... no, hatch offering. So now we just look for hatch and try to find Leon. Alright, hatch is not around Killer Shack. So now let's just make a loop around the rest of the map. For the antidotes, the ones that make you go faster, it's good to throw them far ahead of you because they do take a second to pop up into the yellow gas clouds. You do not get the effect until that cloud turns yellow. All right, here's hatch. Let's close that. All right, we've got one exit gate there and one there. Now, this isn't a huge boost. You do get a 10% from the antidote clouds, but it's better than nothing. All right, nobody there. Let's check this other gate. I'm not seeing anything there. My guess is going to be he's waiting over here. Yep, there's a Leon. All right, let's switch back to the tonic. Now always, if you know that a survivor is waiting on the other side of a pallet, throw a tonic through the pallet to slow them down while you're breaking a pallet and getting it out of the way. They're not gonna create as much distance. It just makes it easier for you to follow it up later. All right, now he... all right, he's on the other side. We're gonna turn around. Yep. So this rock that we just went through, that's a pretty good rock for most killers. Survivors aren't gonna be able to see the red stain as easily through something like that. So you can mind game that pretty easily. All right, well, that's it. That was a pretty standard clown match, I'd say. If you have any questions about Clown, put it down in the comments below. I'd love to help you out and help you play a better Clown. Alright, well, that's gonna do it for me. I hope you enjoyed this video. I hope you learned something. My name is Mr. David Ray, and thank you so much for watching.